Hello.
Georgia Canuck. I came out to this park and then I noticed there was a line of nice big trees along here. There's a school here and the grass strip with the trees belongs to the city. Nobody's gonna complain. I'm not in front of somebody's house here. So I got a 70s quarter there and a penny around there. Then I got a nice '85 signal right here. '85, '87, '86. So I dug down 3-4 inches, I'd say. And I've already seen the target. Just gonna pull it back out. And we've got a nice silver ring. First good target of the day. Nice silver ring. I'll take that any dang day of the week. All right, back if I find something else. Hello, Georgia Canuck. I've been in this park since 9:30, and it's a little after 12 now. Lots of modern pennies and square nails and bullet casings in the woods there. And then I come out here. I was about to get frustrated and I said, I haven't even found one old penny. And I didn't more than take 2 steps when I got a weird banging signal. 60s, 70s. 1932, 1 cent. George V. So, first good find of the day, and I only got like maybe 1 hour and 30 minutes left, so I'm gonna hit this little area in here, see what I can dig up. Alright, back later if I find something else. Couldn't take the camera with me today. Too many people in the park. I wasn't chancing it. Anyway, some short little hunt. Copper plated or chrome plated bangle. Another silver ring from the same place I got the last two. On the curb this time. Crap load of pennies. I think there's a quarter in there and a couple of dimes. Anyway, I hadn't went through to see if there's any oldies yet, but clean it up and post a roundup later. Right. Hello, Georgia Canuck. It's Wednesday, July 18th. I don't know if you can hear me for the traffic on the highway here. I'm right along the edge of the sidewalk on the main front of the park where I found the 2 other silver rings and the fake silver one. Right here at the corner where the path hits the main sidewalk on the street. And I got a 92 signal right here at the corner. And if you can see right here, I got another ring. Another good silver ring. Alright, back later if I find something else. Hello, Georgia Canuck. I'm back out at the same park again today. Thursday, 19th of July. I just left the car down there and I come along the back wall of this hockey rink. And I got an 83-85 signal. Penny was in the top of the plug. It's a 67 Rock Dove Memorial. And I think I've got a silver quarter down here. I think. This sure looks silver to me. Looks like I might have scratched it, but oh yeah, yeah. That's one I've never found before. It's definitely silver. That's a Lynx or Puma or whatever they call it. That's a 67. Should be 19. 67 or I think, hold on a second. Let's see if I can find the date again. I had it a second ago. Where's the date? Yeah, there it is. 1967. That's my first one of those. So, let's make sure there's nothing else in the hole. Yeah. 67 penny, 67 silver quarter. So I got silver today already. All right, back if I find something else. Georgia Canuck. I got up for 1 hour Sunday. I'm on the way home now, just swinging the coil. Crossed a little park here, heading for the parking lot. Got an 85-90 signal. And there she is. Another silver ring. Okay. That's it. I'm headed out home. Good luck and happy hunting, y'all. Hey, it's Georgia Canuck. I'm back out at the same park I got the silver ring at yesterday. Been here about, an hour, 2 hours, somewhere around there. I can't keep track of time. Anyway, there was a lot of people around earlier. And, I couldn't exactly film things, but, let's start off with what I just found. I just found a little earring. I don't think it's real. It looks kind of corroded there. And before that, when there was a lot of people around, I got this. It doesn't look real either. It looks like it's tarnished. It's probably just fake. It's an adult size ring, though. Anyway, I'll clean them up when I get home. We'll see what we got. Back later if I find anything else. Hello, Georgia Canuck. Little roundup for over a week. Today is Thursday night, July 26th. So I'm going back from Sunday before last till now. This is my roundup for all that time. As you can see, I have a pile of pennies here. 70s, 80s, 90s, 2000s, they're all in one pile. There's too many of them to count. There's probably 100 pennies there. About a dollar's worth, maybe. $12 in toonies, $2 coins. $12 in $1 coins, loonies. $10 in 25 cent in quarters. Down here, $2.60 in dimes, $1.15 in nickels, 50 cent in American, 10 cent American,
70s, 80s, 90s, I mean 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s, 2000s and pennies, 8 1960s pennies. This is a Chinese coin made of steel, and it is, come on, why aren't you focusing? Anyway, it's a Chinese foreign coin rusting away. Got a nice $10 Taiwanese coin. There's a Taiwanese gentleman that works on at Home Depot with me, and I asked him to read the date on here, and he said it's about 1997, 1998, because they don't have the $10 anymore. It's $100 or $100. I can't remember what he called the coin. Anyway, moving on. Four different kinds of tokens, including this nice shiny one. Sorry for the dark in here. This light is terrible in the kitchen. I don't have room on the table out there. A lot of people's going to say, when I say crack pipe, a lot of people are going to say, no, that's a marijuana pipe. But this one had the metal, I can't remember the name of it. Anyway, the fuzzy metal wire that you rub things with was in here, so I know it's definitely a crack pipe. Zippo lighter, probably from the 80s. Junk earring. Junk birthstone ring. The silver ring, 925 silver ring that I found 2 days ago. And the hallmarked PL and 14K, 8.5 gram, 14K gold ring. I've had people responding saying PL is not platinum, but I have researched online, and there's people saying it is, and there's people saying it isn't. But one antique dealer definitely says PL is platinum, so this is platinum inlaid, as far as I'm concerned, until a jeweler tells me otherwise after I get it appraised. So if it was 14K, melt value is about $255 if I got 100%, but if it is platinum inlaid, I'm going to say it's probably more up around $300. Anyway, moving on, some kind of bronze something. Fishing weights, keys, toy car, broken keys, dog tag, name of Lily. It's got a phone number on the back. Interesting button. I don't think it's that old, but I don't think it's really recent either. Probably 70s or 60s. Little stick pin that I found yesterday. If I can get it to focus. It says Ontario. North Bay, Ontario, I think, or something like that. Crap. That's my alarm for the laundry. I'll try to hurry this up. Bangles, four bangles, a watch face, some kind of jewelry wire. And that's it. So until next time, glue it and happy hunting, y'all. Sorry, y'all. I went and turned the alarm off. I'm back. Skip past some of my finds. I'm sorry. I turned this today in a ballpark. It's a 1918 large cent. George V large cent. It had to be in the field dirt. I thought it was an American quarter when I dug it up. I just threw it in my pouch and kept going. I know the exact spot that I dug it up. So I'm going back there and really grid that area, because if they brought in field dirt from an old place and this came with it, there's got to be some more nice stuff in there. I moved on away from that area, so I didn't get anything else there. 2 Sundays ago, I got a George V. This camera's being a pain. George V, 1932 penny. Really nice condition. See if I can get this large scent to focus better now. There we go. It's got to be soaked in olive oil to make it look better. I've been soaking that 1932 for a week, and it's looking really, really good. Even after I took it out of the oil, it's keeping it shiny. 1959 D wheat scent I dug last Sunday. Two George Six Peonies. I believe this one is 1946, and the other one, the other one's in much better condition, at least on the front, and it's 1952. Then I got some Young Elizabeths. I got a 56, 62, and 264s. And that's it. Sorry about leaving that out. But anyway, good luck and happy hunting all. Until next time. Now I gotta beat this. Oh boy. Alright, later.